Bin Laden has been financing the Taliban and Al-Qaeda, setting up terrorist training camps all over Afghanistan. He's had one big win on U.S. soil. He wants another. And if we don't stop him, there will be more. Bin Laden might be the brains, but make no mistake about it, in Afghanistan, the Taliban is the muscle. If we remove them from power, he can't use them to make his attacks.
Mazar-e-Sharif. Whoever controls that city controls Afghanistan. If we take Mazar from the Taliban, then we cripple Bin Laden.
Well, that's half right. If you're gonna interrupt me, you should probably be entirely right. No, we aren't taking anything. The man who's gonna take Mazar is named General Dostum. He's an Afghan warlord with the Northern Alliance. He has the troops, he has the intel, he knows the cliffs, he knows every cave, and most importantly, he does not care for the Taliban.
So this is about airstrikes. Sorry, sir.
No, you nailed that one. Dostum cannot take out the Taliban by himself. Here's the plan. We're gonna drop you into Northern Afghanistan. There you will meet up with a CIA operative who will take you to Dostum. Your mission, earn Dostum's trust. Embed with his militia, you fight alongside him while he makes his way to Taliban strongholds. When you get there, you call in for close air support strikes. Dostum will do the rest, one by one, stronghold by stronghold, until he takes Mazar and the Taliban falls. You got 6 weeks.
Well, I'd say 3 weeks, sir.
God damn it. No, no.
All right, I'll bite. Why three?
The Russians have been here before, right? They've done this, and they wrote about it. They said the snow was shutting down all the mountain passes by mid-November. Every year, without fail. Now, if the Russians are talking about a bad winter, it's usually worth paying attention to, isn't it? After 3 weeks, we will not get into Mazar. That snow will hit, the Taliban will dig in, and my men won't come home.
Your air support comes from B-52s at 35,000 feet. How do you think you're gonna get close enough to be accurate without parking a bomb in your lap?
I'll have to get out of the way, sir.
The extra 3 weeks is cushion for your fuck-ups.
There won't be any fuck-ups. 3 weeks is all we need.
Pretty confident for a guy who's never done this before. Never been to war.
Well, I don't see that as a disadvantage, sir.
Well, maybe you should explain that.
We're teaming up with a warlord that we know nothing about. We're not gonna be able to tell our enemies from our allies. Every step we take is gonna be on a minefield from 100 different wars. And no one's ever called in a smart bomb airstrike from a B-52. So anyone who tells you they've done this before, has experience in this, is lying, sir. There's no playbook here. We're gonna have to write it ourselves.
I briefed 5 potential captains for this mission. About 100 years of military experience between them. But you're the only one that sees it the way it is. I choose you. You and 11 men. Task Force Dagger. I would be remiss if I did not say to you, even in success, the odds of you coming home.
They're 100%, sir, with all due respect. So I kind of made a promise, too.
You know better than that, Nelson. What'd she get you to?
Christmas.
It's a hell of a thing we do, isn't it? How do you love your family and leave them to go to war?
Your wheel's up at 2,200. Dismissed. Now, knock that off. Go. Captain. The most important thing a man can take into combat is a reason why. This is from the towers. You carry that with you. 5 weeks ago, 19 men attacked our country. The 12 of you will be the first ones to fight back. Go win this thing.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah!
Son of a bitch, we're the first ones in.
Yeah, it's kind of like the Apollo program. You know what they sent into space first, right?
What?
A monkey.
Right.
Listen, bro. 6 weeks is 6 weeks, okay? We can't rush this. We're in harm's way no matter what the weather. If your only goal is trying to keep us alive, we're dead men for sure.
Hey, I ain't losing one man on this team, Al. The only way home is winning.
Oh, shit, I believe you. Come on, let's tell the boys we're up.